Ito muna. For the figure shown, compute the unstretched length of BD, this member, to hold the 50 kg crate in the position shown. Use K equals 180 Newton per meter. Ayan. So, huwag kang ma-intimidate. Kahit merong spring dyan, the analysis, the equilibrium analysis is still the same if naka-cable yan. So, yan lang yung advice ko pag merong spring. Now, first, we can sum up forces along X. So, we can get the components of this triangle. Diba? Now, the same yung legs ng triangle. 2 saka 2. So, this is a 45 degree right triangle. But, we can just use the components. Gamitan natin ng 2. So, the hypotenuse will be 2 square root of 2. Then, we can reduce the sides. Diba? We can divide all the sides by 2. So, pwede natin yan siyang i-cancel. Magiging 1 na yan. 1, 1 square root of 2. And then, for this side naman, dito na lang yung ratio ko. The horizontal distance is 3 meters. The height is 2. So, the hypotenuse will be square root of 9 plus 4. 9 plus 4 is 13. So, square root of 13. Ayan. Now, if we are to sum up forces along X, then we have ito yung internal force niya. Paganyan, saka ito naman paganyan. So, this is CD, this is BD. So, yung CD, horizontal component niya is acting toward the left. So, negative CD times the component along X, 1, divided by the hypotenuse. So, square root of 2. Then, for BD naman, we have plus kasi to the right yung component niya. Component along the x-axis is 3 divided by square root of 13. Ayan. So, dapat equal yan to 0. And then, summation naman tayo ng forces along the y-axis. So, we have CD. Upward yung dalawang components na yan. So, walang problema. Divide yan by 1 over square root of 2. Then, BD times the vertical component is 2. Divided by square root of 13. Ayan. Then, we must equate that with the weight. Kasi diba, meron tong weight na 50 kilograms. So, gawin na lang natin 50 times 9.81. Now, since this opposes the direction of motion kasi downward siya, then, i-equate na lang natin agad. So, equals 50 times 9.81. Ayan. So, using our calculators, we have mode, then equation, two unknowns. So, for CD, we have negative 1 divided by square root of 2. Then, 3 divided by square root of 13. Tapos, 1 divided by square root of 2. Then, 2 divided by square root of 13. Then, 50 times 9.81. Ayan. So, press equals. Ito yung force ng member CD. Kasi siya yung nauna. So, 416.2. Then, BD naman is 353.7. Naka-newtons yan. So, paano natin makukuha yung unstretched length ng BD? Ito yung concept ng spring displacement. So, delta L must be equal to the displacement caused by the spring. So, sabihin natin D. Ayan. Or, marami sa books, naka-X siya. Yan. So, lagay ko displacement of the spring. Ayan. Now, to solve the displacement of the spring, kailangan natin yung equation na to. F is equal to the spring constant K multiplied by the spring displacement. Ayan. So, meron tayong F. Yan yung force ng member BD. So, di ba, 353.7 yan. Or, ano na lang, isimplify na lang natin to. Solving X, this is going to be F divided by K. Diba? So, delta L is the final length minus the initial length. Equal dapat siya sa spring displacement. Now, the final length is, alam natin, yan yung length na to. Kasi once na-apply na yung force, ito na yung orientation niya. So, diba, this length is square root of 13 from the hypotenuse of this triangle. So, we have square root of 13 minus natin yung initial length, equal yan dapat sa spring displacement. So, the force in BD is 353.7. Divide natin by the spring constant, 180. Kailangan consistent yung units ng force. Naka-Newton yan, so dapat naka-Newton din to. So, kung Kn yung force mo, you need to multiply this by 1,000. Yan. And then, dapat consistent din yung units. Naka-meter yan, so dapat naka-meter yung mga length. So, square root of 13 minus the initial length, that must be equal to the displacement. So, 353.7 divided by 180. Therefore, the initial length is 1.64. Ayan. Move ko na lang to. Yan, dito na lang. So, again, the initial length or the unstretched length is 1.64 meters. Ayan. So, from 1.64, ano siya? Nag-increase siya ng length to square root of 13.